Yeah, I was talking about text, but I was talking about images, and I was talking about sounds, and I was talking about video. So the whole scape of media.
I kind of never even mentioned to my students that they need to cite really not the mention. But I do mention to all the time about
words and texts.
And right. I even say to my eighth graders, you know, when you go to high school, some high schools use term of day.
Right.
And you gotta put your, you know, your work there, and the teacher can check what percent of your work was copied.
Right.
That's plagiarism. But I never said anything about images.
But
I do tell my yearbook committee because we have freedom to upload a photo from anywhere and put it into our yearbook. But things that come, like this year, are topic is more like social media.
Okay.
So like the kids actually, why don't we upload the Instagram page, and I'm like, you can't do that, it's not good. But your YouTube page is wrong.
Right.
And use the templates that we have on our online yearbook page, look at how it looks, make yours, change the colors, change the font size, but you can still make it simple, you can't use that as a trademark. Yes, but when we put documents, what my Christmas wish are,
right.
What are my wishes for Christmas, and they copy and paste it to the third graders and Santa Claus,
right.
I have everything to tell them, and really can't do that, it's not yours, so you should tell me where you got it from. In a slideshow for my fifth grades, I ask them, give me the link where you got it from,
right.
Or
right.
Your pictures, or the movie that you have embedded in
right.
The slideshow, where did you get from? But for a photo, I can never.
And you know, the beautiful thing for us as educators is there is that fair use law. And so, you know, if you think about 5 or 10 years ago, we never would have to have this conversation because the photos stayed inside the building. So if you have George Washington on a piece of paper and you print it and hang it on the wall, who cares? It's staying in the building.
It's absolutely still true that that's okay.
Totally okay. But it is also totally okay to do that in online spaces as long as you're following the laws of fair use, which we're going to clarify a little bit more today. But we're going to come back to this over and over and over again because there's a lot of judgment involved in is something really fair use or not. And speaking of yearbook, I mean, this is really like the beginnings of why I had to begin thinking about this. In 2002, I took on the yearbook. And at first, it was whatever went on the yearbook page, went on the yearbook page. But then I think our yearbook company may have gotten, either they got in trouble, or school got in trouble, whatever it was. Suddenly it became, you can't put anything in your yearbook page has a corporate logo like Coke or like a Wilson basketball.
Because now that's for profit.
Right, exactly. And so that was like 2002, 2003. And oh my gosh, I mean, almost drop down, drag out fights between the kids and myself and the eighth grade teacher. I don't understand why I can't have a Coke bottle. And that was the year I started teaching them what does copyright mean, what does fair use mean. And by my last year there, 2 years ago, I had never, ever a problem with images because the kids just really, from the time that they were in kindergarten, when I do the fair use, the lesson, it was called, I don't even remember what it was called, but it was basically like I'm the author. And in the Creative Commons classroom series, it's a printout with a picture frame. You ask the kindergartner to draw a picture, and then you ask them to take a picture in pencil and sign the picture, and they say, look at that. You really are a mother. You can choose what happens with this piece of work. And then, you know, you scaffold year and year and year, and by the time you're doing your book in eighth grade, they're just like totally on board with, oh yeah, I can't do that. But then on the other hand, if you're in a picture holding a model of Coke with your friends, that's okay because it's fair use. And so there's a lot to think about. How about this concept? How much trouble do you have with your students? And maybe maybe if they've never cited images, you've never had this trouble. But so many kids, especially 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th graders, will cite Google images. So
if
what's
I
the
learned that Google is not a website for reference because they think they went to Google and they took it somewhere.
Yes.
I think they finally gotten that. But when it comes to the images, they haven't learned that yet. That
right.
That's actually a website somewhere else. Yeah.
That's a huge, huge bit of learning. And you know, we're all the elementary teachers. So really, if you can just by 8th grade get them to begin understanding these concepts, you set them up for the learning in high school and college. But I can't tell you how often I would have kids redo citations because they would say Google Images. And if it helps you, what I would say is if you go to the library, if I go to Roselle Park Library and I get a book out, well, I'm not going to cite Roselle Park Library anywhere in my paper. And Google's the same way. It, like you said, it just points you to it. But you then have to analyze it and say, so where did it really come from? So that's a really hard thing for kids to understand, that you're not getting it from Google. And you know, there's the big learnings, hopefully, that you took away if you got a chance to look at the pre-work is, first of all, copyright is a constitutional right, which, how crazy is that? Our forefathers back in the 1700s were thinking about this, but they weren't thinking about it to hold money for people, which is, I think, what most of us think about right now. Copyright means I'm going to earn money. They really intended it so that, intellectually people can't hold on too tight, but yet you might have an idea that you can copyright and spark somebody else to take your idea further. The other thing that a lot of people confuse is that copyright happens the instant you take your hand off the paper. If I was feeling wild and I created a dance in front of me, the instant I recorded that dance and play it back and write down the steps, that's copyrighted material. The instant I start singing the song and then transcribe my original song, I've got copyright on that. But then we've got people who are famous. I mean, Adele, she put out a new piece of music. She's going to fill out a form, and she's going to send it for $25 or whatever.
Let's see. That's what I need some clarification on. If you did a dance here,
right?
How can that be copyrighted? You know what I'm saying? It's not documented.
Right, and what I would do, I mean, like, I'm not a dancer, but if
no,
I was a dancer, and I gave you a real bit in a moment, and I write it down on paper, or I record it on a videotape, I now have evidence that these are the steps, and this is the pattern, and this is mine.
Legally, you can prosecute somebody for repeating exactly what you did. See, I thought you had to have a little copyright symbol before.
And years ago, that was the case,
okay.
But they rewrote copyright law a decade or two ago. And so a decade or two ago, you had to put a C in the circle with the date and your name in order to claim copyright.
Yes.
But then when copyright law changed in the last couple decades, it became the instant you put your pen off the paper, you already own the copyright to that.
That's tough to track, though. But
it is. And that's why, you know, these artists like Adele, I took a picture of something called a school in a box that the United Nations puts out, and that one I put up with something that we're going to talk about next month called Creative Commons. And it was fascinating. I got an email through Flickr from Pearson, who wanted to use that picture in one of their textbooks. And since I put a Creative Commons license on it that said attribution and non-commercial, they couldn't just pull the photo.
Pearson
needs
not.
Doing textbooks.
Right.
Textbooks. Yes, Pearson did.
Their name is on the app.
Yeah, they
helped.
But you know, it was very cool because they wanted to use it, but by my rights, they weren't allowed to because I said non-commercial, and they asked to use it, and I didn't care. So I said, yeah, sure, go right ahead. I didn't even ask them, what would you give an artist who contributes a photo? But you know, if you as a human in our society choose to do something creative, and this is really where I came to with my students by the time they were in eighth grade, if you do something creative, you deserve